Hello everyone, I'm Rekha Miss from DAPS. Today, I'm going to discuss with you short questions, which is based on information related to days, months, and times. Let's solve the first question. Here is a weekly schedule of activities that Belal does in his free time. Now, write the names of the days of the week in sentences. And clue is given that Saturday is the first day of the week. So, we can understand that this question is related to days. So now we are asked to write the names of the days. Also, we have to write in a sentence form. So I'm going to show you how we can solve it. This is the activities. And it's mentioned the days of the week, and then the second column is for activities. So these are the ordinal numbers. So already we have seen that the first day of the week is Saturday. So if the first day of the week is Saturday, obviously the second day is Sunday. So how we can start our writing? Let's see. We can start on Sunday, then comma. Oh, one more thing. We have to remember that preposition on goes with days. So please, you have to remember this. So on Sunday, whose activities we are doing? Let's see. Belal's activities. So on Sunday, Belal watches cartoons on TV. So let's see the second one, fourth day. We don't have third day. So according to this, fourth Sunday is second day. So Monday is third day. So fourth day is Tuesday. So let's begin our sentence again. On Tuesday, instead of Belal, we are going to write he. This is a pronoun. So on Tuesday, he, see, this one fourth day, what does he do? He cleans reading room. So on Tuesday, he cleans reading room. So again, fifth day. After Tuesday comes Wednesday. So on Wednesday, he practices music. Practices music. Right after this sentence, you can start your next sentence. So sixth day. Sixth day is Thursday. On Thursday, comma, what does he do? He works in the vegetable garden. Okay, full stop. Now the last one is seventh day. So which one is seventh day? The seventh day is Friday. So on Friday, he plays cricket. This is the way we can solve the answer. Now let's move to question number two. Question number two is, here is a schedule of different occasions that you celebrate in your school in different months. Write the name of the months when you celebrate these occasions. Now this question is related to months. And see, you don't have the clue here that the January is the first month of the year. But we know that January is the first month of the year. So according to this, we have to do this. We have to solve this answer. Okay. Now, the first month. So we can start writing like this. In January, comma. Now you may have a question, huh? Why it is in? Preposition in always goes with months. So in January, we celebrate book fair. Now, second month. In February, we celebrate International Mother Language International Mother Language Day. Okay, full stop. Now, third month. In March, comma, we celebrate Independence Day. Okay, now fourth month is April. So again, in April we celebrate International Children's Day. Okay, next. Oh, cut, please, cut. I made a mistake. So, in April, we celebrate Bangla New Year. Then we don't have 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th months. We have 11th month. So in November, we celebrate International Children's Day. Now let's see the last month is December. So in December, we celebrate Victory Day. This is the way we can solve the second question. Now, let's see the third question. The third question is, here is a schedule of daily activities of a teacher. Teacher's name is not mentioned, so you can choose a teacher's name and you can write down. Write 5 sentences using the hours of the day when your teacher does these activities. So question number 3, it's clear for us that this quotient is related to times. So this is the schedule of teacher's activities. First column is about the hours of the day, and the second column is about the activities. So it's written, it's telling about, it says about the time. So suppose your teacher, suppose your teacher is Mr. Islam. Okay, so Mr. Islam, you can start from your activities, then you will, at last you will mention the time. So Mr. Islam gets up at 6 a.m. Okay, now second one. Instead of Mr. Islam, again I am writing he, preposition he. He makes lesson plan at 7 a.m. And let's see, next, what does he do? He goes to school. When does he go to school? At 9 a.m. At 9 a.m. Now, next one, 4 p.m. What does he do? He goes for playing. Okay, so he goes to play at 4 p.m. Now, the last activity, he watches TV at 7 p.m. So, my dear friends, today we have solved three questions based on days, months, and times. I hope you all have understand today's topic, and I hope you will be able to solve some of the exercises from your textbook. You can solve some exercises from your communicative English grammar and composition book, and these exercises starts from page number 288. So this is my request to you. Please, you study at home and stay safe. Bye. See you again.